Hi, I'm going to draw a little bit more complicated free body diagram in this example. We're going to draw free body diagrams for a car that's accelerating to the right. And we're going to go ahead and assume that the drag force or air resistance is significant. Oftentimes with physics problems, we just ignore this force, but we're going to make the claim that in this physical situation, the drag force is significant. Okay, and before we draw our free body diagram, sometimes it's useful to think about the acceleration and the net force first. So let's go ahead and do that, and then we'll worry about the actual free body diagram. So the acceleration is pointing to the right. Okay, and so according to Newton's second law, the vector sum of the forces has to also point to the right. So our free body diagram should be consistent with this claim. So if you'd like to go ahead and pause the video, you can draw the free body diagram for yourself, and then you can compare your work to mine. Okay, so once again, I'm just going to start with the easiest force to think about. It's the weight force. So I have a weight force exerted by the Earth directed down. Okay, and we're drawing a free body diagram for the car. So second subscript for all my forces is going to be C for car. Okay, so then looking at this claim right here, there is no acceleration in the vertical direction, therefore there's no net force in the vertical direction. So something is preventing the car from plummeting to the center of the Earth, and that would be the road. Okay, so we assume this car is driving on a road, so normal force from the road on the car. Okay, now notice that the second subscript is the same. Certainly it isn't false to claim that the road exerts a force on the tires, but typically we don't break the object up into pieces. Okay, it's the car in its entirety has a force exerted upon it. Okay, so then let's think about the horizontal direction. It's accelerating to the right, net force to the right. So what is providing that force? Now it's tempting to think of this situation as being something to do with the engine, okay? But the engine is actually inside the car, and the source of the force has to be external to the object in question. So we can't attribute the force to the engine. Now the engine is certainly important. Without it, the car isn't going to go anywhere. But in terms of forces, the engine is not exerting an external force on the car. It's part of the car. Okay, so instead we need to think about what's outside the car that's exerting a force on it. And the fact that there is a normal force actually is suggestive that there is also a friction force. So there's always often a connection between normal force and friction force. So there is a friction force to the right, and I don't know which one of these is bigger. I know that these two are the same length, but I just don't have enough data to make a claim about the friction force. So I'll just draw it of more or less random length. And so typically we use the symbol lowercase f to indicate friction. Now another strange thing about this situation is that it is actually static friction between the road and the car. So because the tires presumably aren't slipping, now if the person's peeling out, then it would be kinetic friction, but it's actually static friction under normal driving conditions because the tires aren't slipping or sliding with respect to the road. So it's actually static friction, and so we're actually gonna have three subscripts here. So static friction exerted by the road on the car. And so there's both a mathematical and a causal connection between these two forces, between the normal force and the friction force. They both have the same source and receiver. Okay, and I said earlier that there is a significant drag force, but I need to make sure that I draw it so that this claim is upheld. So I'm gonna draw a force to the left that's smaller than the friction force. So drag force exerted by the air on the car to the left. Okay, so that's it. A lot of sort of tricky things here, but hopefully you'll get used to this with some practice. Thanks.